Hey guys, Stitching May here. Gonna do my September, my monthly September video. I got a few things to do. I got to do the September tag. I've got to show you my whips. And I have to show you the haul that I told you about that I ordered last month. I hadn't come in the mail yet. And then, of course, this month's haul. I do have a lot to tell you, so I have made a few notes. So if you see me looking down, please ignore me. I just don't want to forget anything. I guess I'll start with the September tag. Let me tell you first that my husband and my son have stepped out of the house, and they're due back any moment, so you may hear them come in on the video, and I probably won't be able to edit it out. So if you hear that, I apologize. But so I'll start with the September tag, and it was, the first question was, if you have a favorite color of do you have a favorite color of DMC, and if so, what is it? And I don't really have a true favorite color for DMC. You guys know that teal blues and greens are my favorite color, and I guess I would probably lean towards those, but there are so many colors in DMC that if I try to look through and pick one favorite out, I couldn't. I would have 10, 20 of them. I'm not one that can never pick one favorite. Like, there's nothing that I can say, well, I could have this for the rest of my life and be done. I'm very eclectic. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, but you know. But so usually I have like a favorite color per project. So right now, of all the projects I'm doing, I guess my favorite color of them would be 958, which is sea green dark. And the only reason I know the description is because this was a kit and it was kitted with DMC and they had the description listed. Don't remember, you know, all of the descriptions. There's that. I don't know how that's showing up. It's a very mild teal green color. They call it sea green. Okay, and I guess my second favorite, because like I said, I can't ever choose one favorite, it would be 996, and it's also in Starry Night, and it's called Electric Blue. I think Jess Marie Does Stuff has mentioned this color before in the past. It's a very bright, I tend to like the bright colors. Usually the color that I like the most, it grabs me when I first start the project, and that's the symbol that I memorize first. And then I'm drawn to it. Every time I see the symbol, I get kind of excited because I get to use that color again. I'm in a happy camper, oddly enough. I'm not a big fan of yellow, but it was the yellow of the sun. I want to say it was 941. Don't hold me to that. 941, I think maybe that really bright, annoying orange that you may like, and I apologize if you do. But anyway, it was like a 900 color, and it was really pretty. It was just a very bright color, and it didn't look as bright as it did in a pattern. It's so weird the way whenever you stitch with the color, it looks completely different on the fabric or with the other colors. Because when I first saw the yellow, I was like, oh, I may have to tone that down some. But then when I put it on the cream fabric with all the colors, it looked great. Speaking of Happy Camper, it's at the framers now. Hopefully we'll get it back this week because we're kind of on deadline. Hopefully it'll come back this week. But anyway. So I tend to have a favorite color per project, and I look really forward to stitching with that color each time. The number two book, or the number two question, was about books, and I think the original question was, do you read, and if so, what's on your nightstand? This question has grown, and because of that, my to read list has grown. But I will say that I don't get to read as much as I wish I could. Before I stitched as hardcore, is that a word for stitching, hardcore? Before I stitched as much as I do now, I was a pretty avid reader. Now, I didn't read necessarily like the classics or 100 books a year. I just read a lot of various books. Now that I'm stitched so much, it can be hard to read because you can't stitch and read at the same time. So then I got into audiobooks. I rent them from my library and I listen to them through Overdrive Media. I don't know if your libraries have that. If you like audiobooks, though, check it out. I know it works here in the U.S. It's Overdrive Media. You check out the book and it returns it when it's due. No late fees or anything. So anyway, there's that little plug. It's an app you can get on your phone, on your tablet, on your computer. So anyway, but my husband vowed to me when we moved into this house 4 years ago that he would never buy me another book again, because after having to move the books, he said they were too heavy, and he bought me an e-reader, a Nook, one of the second generation Nooks, you know, the ones with the free Wi-Fi, 3G, and it's the black and white, the ones they don't make anymore, and I love that one. I will never upgrade. Hopefully that one will never break. But and since then, he stuck to that. He's only bought me e-cards. When my son was born, I mentioned that he was sick and he couldn't nurse. So I had to pump, and I had 15 minutes every 2 hours for a good 10 months that I would sit and read. And let me tell you, I went through books pretty quickly on my e-reader. And then after that, it's kind of slowed down. I started, like I said, I started stitching again, and I couldn't read and stitch at the same time. And now, since FlossTube, I end up spending my time watching YouTube videos and stitching instead of listening to audiobooks and stitching. So it's even slowed down. But right now, on my nightstand would be the book Still Alice by Lisa Genova. You've probably never heard this author. I think she's got like maybe two books out. And it's not a standard, like it's not a best, I don't know if it's a bestseller, but it's not in one that you hear in the news and the media often. This was actually a recommendation from my boss. I work in an inpatient rehab unit, which is therapy, like hip replacements and stuff, not drug rehab. And this book is about a woman she is a cognitive psychology professor at Harvard. And then she starts becoming more and more disoriented, and then she gets diagnosed with Alzheimer's essentially. And it's just about her life going from this completely functional, very intelligent woman to a woman with Alzheimer's and how it affects her life. And we deal with that disease a lot at my work, and it's a very, very, very sad disease. So my boss recommended this book to all of us to read. This is actually her copy. I have to give back to her because I bought a copy at a used book sale for like 25 cents. But so I it's so far a very interesting book. I'm maybe 100 pages into it, and it jumps right in. So I think most of the book is going to be about her. You find out about her starting to get disoriented within like the first 20 pages. So I didn't really ruin anything. I don't know a lot about the book, so I can't tell you. But if you're interested in Alzheimer's disease at all, just it's a definitely book to check out. Other than that, I guess Nora Roberts and Nicholas Sparks would have to be my two. Oh, and Janet Ivanovich would have to be my three favorite artists. Arthur, see, again, I can't pick a favorite. I've got three. Janet Ivanovich has great, very light-hearted, hilarious books. They're called the Stephanie Plum series. There's like one for the money, two for the dough, three to get ready, and they're all based on the numbers. And then there are like four in between novels. So I think there's a total of 21 books out, plus the four in between books right now. Lots of bottles. But anyway, and again, that's Janet Ivanovich, and I didn't grab one of her books, but she's hilarious. It's about a girl who is a she was a lingerie buyer for a company, and her job gets deleted in the economy. And so she goes to her cousin, who owns a Bell Bonds company, and she looks for a job in filing, and the only thing he has open is a bounty hunter job. So she's like a lingerie buyer turned bounty hunter, and it's just hilarious. It's a very funny book, very easy to listen to. If you're into audiobooks, check it out, because it's a very light book to listen to, and you don't have to keep up, you can just listen. And then, of course, Nora Roberts. Again, another light reads. I like to listen to her audiobooks as well. And Nicholas Sparks, he's just one of the best romance authors out there. So, for my three random facts, my first one would have to be about food. I'm a nurse. I deal with many bodily functions, and they do not bother me. I can, talk about some horrendous things while I eat lunch. It's one of the things about being a nurse. Bodily functions don't bother you. Let me see spoiled food or smell spoiled food, and I'm done. I'm sick, and I mean sick, sick. To the so bad that when my husband and I first moved in together, we had a refrigerator, and it was an older refrigerator, and the thermostat messed up, and it got so cold that it burst a glass jar of jelly. The jelly was fine. It was not spoiled. It was just the act of cleaning it up. I was sick. He thought that was hilarious. I cannot stand to think about people messing with my food in a restaurant. I do eat out, but I have to try it. If I we've left restaurants before because I saw somebody, a worker, come out of the bathroom playing with their hair and not wash their hair after they touched their food. And it wasn't even the server, it was like the hostess. And we left. We got our drinks and left. I mean, you don't mess with my food. I can't do it. Especially seeing Cleaning out the refrigerator is my husband's job. If there's spoiled food, I can't do it. I can't even wash the dishes of it. So anyway, that's number one. Number two would be that I'm actually kind of shy. It's weird. I can go up into a store and talk to random people. I can make friends fairly easy. But when it comes to actually talking to somebody, like if you put me up on a stage, oddly enough, I can talk to the camera, I guess, because I don't know why y'all aren't really here. But if you put me up on stage or put me in the center of attention, I break out in a sweat and my heart starts racing and I turn all red on my neck and my face, and it's just not a pretty sight. So I'm fine as long as I'm not like the center of attention. I guess I'm fine as long as I don't think people are really listening to me. I can ramble to people as long as I don't know they're really listening to me. And number three would be that hubby and I are high school sweethearts. We were younger when we met, but I was 17 when we started dating. He was 18. I was a junior in high school when we met and a senior when we started dating. And I wouldn't have it any other way. We know each other. We drive each other crazy. People are always like, oh, we've only been married for 8 years. You shouldn't be driving each other this crazy. Well, yeah, but we've been together for 13 years. So, like, he is definitely my best friend. And I just wouldn't have it any other way. I don't know how the dating world works these days. I would not be able to date in this time. Okay, so that's everything for there. Now I will get to the whips, and I'm going to start with my finishing of my Halloween sampler from AAN. I finished it in another wall hanging, and I put more tabs on it this time to hang it by. And I just was going to show you, see if I can get close enough for you to see these colors. These colors, I don't know if you can see the fabric, and I'm sure you can there. These colors match this fabric so well. And this was when I took the piece with me to the shop. But again, they just were having a sale on their Halloween fabrics, and it was a perfect match. I mean, I was very impressed with the way these colors match. You know, it's just there's nothing in it. It just looks kind of baggy because it's so heavy. And then the back's just the solid fabric. And I don't want to get too close because you'll see all the mistakes. Oh my gosh. This thing has been... See, I've still got stupid string. You can't see it, but I still got string that I need to trim off. but this piece has been horrible to me from the beginning. And it was even horrible to me in finishing it. I got some of that fun yarn with the little wispies that I was going to try to just hang it from instead. And I got it all finished, and it was so heavy that whenever it hung, it just kind of did like that, so it wasn't going to work. So when I tried to rip out the stitches, I ended up ripping the part of the actual cotton fabric, almost ripped the work. I literally had done, like, one night, I had a really scary situation. The first night I was sewing, when I sewed these two top pieces on, I had to cut all the fabric, I had a moment where my vision went really blurry, and I don't know, it went away. I think it was because I was concentrating so hard and was so tired. I'm gonna keep a check on it though. Hopefully that's all it was. I had a really bad headache afterwards. I don't know if it was like an aura before a migraine or what. I really think I was just concentrating on plaid fabric way too hard, and it made my eyes kind of go cross. But anyway, so I didn't get a lot done that night. I had cut all the fabric and just stitched on these two top pieces. So the next night, I was stitching on these pieces and the back, and I had done all that and even had this, and I had to undo it all except for one piece of side fabric because of all the holes that got in it. The back piece ripped. I had to recut the back piece. It was a nightmare, so much that my husband was like, you need to put it down. You're supposed to enjoy this, and this is not relaxing you. And I wouldn't. I was like, no, I'm determined. I'm gonna finish this. So I did finish it, and that's how I finished it, in just a wall hanging. And I'm really digressing a lot today, and I apologize for that. I'll try not to do that anymore. Right. Okay, and then my next one would be my AAN Christmas Cardinal Ball, which I've probably worked on the most this month. And then I realized that I hadn't given you guys an update on what this had looked like. And I'm going to eventually, I've downloaded a new software for video editing that I'm gonna try to insert pictures. I can insert pictures now of like what it was before I show you the work, but it will just be this big silent spot. And I found a program that if I can figure it out, if it's not smarter than I am, I can talk over the pictures while I'm showing the picture and then continue. And I've got to figure out the project for the program first. But anyway, that'll be on the next video. Something to come, I guess. But that's where I am on Christmas Cardinal Ball. I have about three-fourths. Anyway, 3 1/4 pages left to finish this whole entire project. And this is what I'm working on that I take to work on breaks. So, because it's easy, it's two colors, and it's an easy chart to follow. I do have to frog a lot, because at work I'll get mixed up where I was and that kind of thing. But it's okay. Makes it interesting, makes it fun. But I'm absolutely loving this red. I love the way it fades in and fades out. It's so Christmassy to me. I'm really proud of the color choice there. And I think if they have more of this fabric when I go to the LNS on vacation next month, I'm so excited that I'm going to get some more of this fabric, because I like this fabric too. I don't know how ironing it's going to do. I'm kind of worried about that though. I'm going to have to check into that. But there that is. And then I'll work more on Starry Night. I got about, 200 or 300 stitches done on Starry Night. I don't know, I'm not sure. And I'll show you that. And I'm not parking now. I just leave it pulled to the front when I have to stop my thread. Here's Starry Night now. And I think I was kind of even, or maybe just a little bit over here. But I have filled that bottom section in a lot more. And I am going by color all the way through the page. But there, sorry, now I'm going to fold it down where you can kind of see just where I was working instead of the whole thing. Whoops. There we go. And this right now is probably my favorite piece. I just love all the colors. Love all the colors that are this. There's not a single color that I don't like in it. Even the black. Black's usually a boring color to me, but it's even a lot of fun in this because it show mixed definition. But now, I was told that Van Gogh actually didn't use any black in the actual painting. That it was all where he had blended. I don't know if that's true or not, but I've been told that. I should have researched that fact before I told y'all that, just in case it's a lie. And then, of course, I worked on 99 bottles, and I didn't get as much done on it. I don't know if you'll be able to see it, because this fabric kind of gets secure. Let's do this. Let me be worse, though. Anyway, I didn't get a lot of the bottles done. I did get more of the shelving done. These top two shelves I finished out right here. And each, this is double. There are two stitches. And it's 62 stitches out. So that's about 240 stitches in itself. And then each bottle is about 100 stitches. And I think I had to re-stitch this bottle completely. And I finished two other bottles. So I got about 500 or 600 stitches done on this one this month. So it's really coming along. I think I've got 26 total bottles done now. And I still absolutely love working on this project too. I like that each bottle is like a finish. Hold it up a little bit longer. That way you guys can see it. Okay. And that's all of my whips, because I only have three that are in my rotation right now. And that's Starry Night, AAN, and then, of course, the bottles. And I worked on all three this month. That's the first time in a long time that I've done that. Okay, so now I'm going to do the last month's haul, which is for the Mirabia stitch along. You guys know I'm doing Emerald Dragon, and I don't have that in front of me to show it to you. I should have brought it with me. But I ordered all my stuff from Crazy Annie Stitching through on Bonanza. And Bonanza is kind of like an Etsy, except it's not all crafts. Bonanza is this page where they all have booths, and then you order from a booth and that kind of thing. And she got a booth on Bonanza. And you do have to be a member of Bonanza like you do for Etsy to order from them. But I absolutely love her store. There was a problem this month. Like I said in the last video, this was the longest shipping I've ever had from her. Long story short, she had moved, and so she got behind on her orders anyway, and then she had a big sale, and then apparently my package got lost in the mail, because she had shipped it and it should have been here, but she reshipped it no charge to me, and I'm just waiting on one crinic. There was only one crinic that she didn't have in her stock that she's going to have to reorder for me. So I'm gonna start with acrylic, because most of Emerald Dragon is stitched in acrylic, so it's kind of scary. There's this beautiful 015, and these are all number 4 braids. And number 015, they're just, I did look these up for you, is called Chartreuse. Sticky Stitch, you'll like that color. It's a very bright, bright green. I don't know if you can see it. I guess I should take it out. I don't want to open all the packaging stuff. 015, Chartreuse. Okay, and then I'll just randomly pick them up. This one is 9294, which is called Periwinkle. If I can't open them easily, I'll just open them so you can see them. It's Periwinkle. 9294 is kind of a periwinkle blue. And here's the Chartreuse again. Chartreuse. I can't say that word. Chartreuse. And then I've got number 684, which is called Aquamarine. I should have done this before the video. I'm sorry. I didn't think about y'all not being able to see through the package. And that's the Aquamarine. I've got like 9 skeins or bobbins of Krennic. So. And here my husband comes in the door, so we're going to do a little bit loud when my son first comes to the door. And this one is 002J, which is Japan Gold. Just a nice, and that's a high luster one. That's not, you know, they've got some of the ones that have different lusters. And then we have 014, which is sky blue. Just a really pretty sky blue. I don't know if y'all can see that or not. And then we have, I've opened these ahead of time. I didn't even speak about the rarity on the package. This one is 027, which is called Orange. That's a very, very basic description.
Mama.
Yes, baby.
You went and
rode in the truck. Okay. Go find daddy, okay? And then this one is 011HL, another high luster, which is gunmetal high luster. And then they, one more acrylic, and it is number 5982, which is forest green. And the one that she's going to have to send out is 085, and it's called Peacock. And it's a number 4 braid. These are all number 4 braids. And then I have my Mill Hill beads. Let me just push them to the side. I'll organize them later. And oddly enough, I think things got kind of mixed up. I needed one of the treasures, but she sent me 2 packs of the beads, which amazes me because I think I spent like $30 on all this, including shipping. And like 1, 2, 3 stitch, just the beads and the acrylics were gonna be like $45 before I even got to shipping. So let's see here. And she actually sent me 2 of each color and only 1 of the treasures. I think I may have told her wrong. But anyway, let me make sure I got the other color so I don't show you the same color twice. And these are 012011, which is called Victorian Gold. If you can see that or not, let me get close. And then I have the same one. I have 42010, which is Ice Petite. It's just a clear bead. I don't know if y'all can even see these or not. I'm going to get halfway across the table though. And then I have 10041. Abalone Magnifica. There you go, that's that color. He's ready to eat. And then I have 03056. And it is antique red. And then I have the two treasures. This one is 13003, which they're just crystals. They're little flat kind of round beads. You're not able to see those. And then I have 13011, which is the same flower. It's just, they're just different colors. This one's kind of a teal green color. And this one is kind of one of those that looks brown, purple, green. You can't see him. I can't see him. You're not able to see him. And he's having a fit because he wants to come in here and play with all my stuff. That's the way it is. So, my haul for this month. I did really good this month. I actually only spent, including what I got at Labor Day, I only spent, I think, $26.10. So, I went $1.10 over my amount that I'm supposed to send or spend. And I'll show you what I got. I got a lot at a Friends of the Library book sale. He is upset because he wants his mama. He wants to be in here and play with his stuff. I got a lot of stuff there for like 10 cents a piece. So I'm just going to kind of go quickly through this to where you won't have to listen to my kid scream because he's having a meltdown. So this is the Garfield book. This one was 10 cents. My aunt loved Garfield. So I just had to get it and she stitched. So I had to get it in memory of her. I don't know that I'll ever do anything with it. But with 10 cents, I couldn't say no. And then this one was 10 cents. It was just an alphabet letter what is it called? Anyway, when you put your letters on it. I cannot think of the word of that right now. Oh my goodness. But, that's it. And then I got this American folk art one for 10 cents as well. Almost done now. And then several of the old Cross Stitch and Country Cat Craft magazines that I'm sure you guys aren't interested in. These were all 10 cents a piece. These I got at the Goodwill for 99 cents. They're the same magazine. I've always loved the picture of Santa praying over the manger. I got that one for 99 cents as well. Just random little magazines. Ooh, something fell out of it. And then I got this at the Goodwill. It was $1.91, and it's a complete kit, including glass and frame. It's like fall leaves and stuff. I thought that was really neat. Even if I just use it for the frame and not the pattern as much. But it's made by the dimensions. And then I got another Just Cross Stitch, one of the first Just Cross Stitch magazines.